molestation case against Michael Jackson returns to court tomorrow, and throughout the ordeal, the pop star's family has been squarely in his corner. Early Show national correspondent Hattie Kaufman sat down with some of the youngest members of the Jackson clan for an exclusive interview.
This is the home where Michael Jackson grew up. Now living there are some of Michael's nephews and a niece. For the first time, they spoke on the record, telling us how they feel about being part of this very famous family.
We're like every other family out there. I don't understand. Like, people think that we're so different, but no, we're not.
Do you have homework like anybody else?
Yeah.
But they also have a musical heritage comparable to none.
You probably have seen those old clips of the Jackson 5. Do you think, wow, they were our age, and look what they were doing?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Is it fun to watch?
Yeah. Yes.
So do you feel pressure, since you're like maybe the next generation of Jacksons? Look, I got 5 sitting right here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, sometimes. Sometimes, but not all the time, because, you know, our parents understand, like...
That they don't push us.
Yeah. They don't pressure us to be something that we don't want to be.
Randy wants to be an actor.
Not to me!
Dante, a lawyer.
Nah, you're pulling it.
See, Jaafar hopes to be the next Tiger Woods, his little brother, Your Majesty, right behind him. That leaves Genevieve to carry on the musical tradition.
You will always be the one for me. Ah, yes, you will.
Now, how old are you?
I'm 14.
14. Wow. Look out.
Jermaine Jackson says the kids have not been interviewed before.
Why did you decide that you wanted America to see the kids?
Because I felt that it was important to show the public that we have children. We are just like any other family. Mm. We're like the Brady Bunch, but we're the Jackson Bunch.
Which means your average family with perks. Not every 8-year-old gets golf instruction from 2 pros.
No more from the inside, babe.
He has a natural swing, you know, he just does it natural. And I think he will have no problem becoming a champion.
It's fun to play, because I want to be like Tiger Woods.
You want to be like Tiger? But what is it that you love?
Good.
What makes it fun?
Chipping and putting and driving.
But he's going to make us proud one day. My dream is to see him and Your Majesty develop into great golfers.
But 4-year-old Your Majesty may have other plans, following in his uncle's footsteps, moonwalking all the way.
I mean, Your Majesty, every day, I can't even play any other music but Michael's on my CD in the car.
They say their best times are when Michael's there to cheer them on.
What's it like when he comes here to visit?
It's so much fun.
Everybody says fun?
We play like hide and go seek,
yeah,
go swimming. He still has that childhood in him, you know? And I love that about him. That's what I love. Like, we, during the summer, we went to Miami to spend the 4th of July there. And we were just lighting up fireworks. It was so much fun.
Sometimes the kids have Neverland all to themselves.
Sometimes we have, like, family days. So then all the family comes to see each other, and then we have a lot of fun.
What's your favorite thing to do?
I like to go on the rides or watch movies.
How about you, Jaafar?
Going to the zoo and going to the arcade.
What they don't like is being teased at school, since their Uncle Michael has been charged with child molestation.
Sometimes, like, random kids that you don't even know just come up to you, and they just ask you things, and then sometimes we don't know what to say because they're just crazy questions, right?
What does it do inside when that's happening?
It hurts us, but then we get over it because, you know, my mom and dad has always taught us to stay strong.
Be tough.
Yeah. Don't let anyone put you down.
Tomorrow, more on how the kids are coping with the unwelcome spotlight. For The Early Show, Hattie Kaufman, CBS News, Los Angeles.
Also tomorrow, Hattie takes us on a tour of the Wall of Fame that Michael Jackson created inside the family home. Jackson family tradition. Everybody's in show business.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, and you do?
Sing.
You sing?
Yeah.
What should we talk about, like,
like
what people said about it and stuff?
Okay.
Then after I'll stand up and show my, and show her back. Yeah.
But is this for him to sit down and just show this?
Huh?
Is this supposed to stay seated and I thought you
Well, Jermaine Dupri, he loved it. He loved all the stitching, the colors, and Chris Tucker and Usher liked it. They loved it. And the, everyone was asking about it, like, where'd you get it and everything, and who designed it and everything.
What do you like about the
I love the color, and it's actually my favorite color line. Like, for, it's better than ice cream, I think. It looks tighter.
I like Candy Fresh Clothing because
I like all the colors and the stitching and the, like, the designs on the back and everything. And it's like kind of my favorite clothing line because I like it's better than ice cream and BBC and stuff.
Well, I guess you gotta say the truth.
He went hard. Yo.
Why do you think it's better than ice cream?
I think it looks tighter. There's more designs. Yeah.
It's too hot.
Show the back.
So you already said it.
I'm just wondering, is anything else maybe you want to tell about, like, talking about you?
No, not going.
No, that's good enough. Okay. That sounds great.
Okay, cool. So then just yeah, stand up and turn to the back.
Motor a little bit. Stand up straight.
So maybe he could say, and here we have my brother, or I don't know.
No, because we'll just have the Chiron. It's just the
stun gun. First of all, how did you even know what a stun gun was?
Well, one of my friends had it, and it was a gift for my dad. And when I ordered it, I wasn't aware it was going to be this big.
So you saw it like in a catalog or something? Or?
Yeah, it was a website and there's like different tasers.
So you're saying that your dad actually showed you...
No, he didn't show me. He didn't know nothing about it.
You ordered the stun gun for your dad?
Yeah, but he didn't know nothing about it.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Now, why did you think your dad wanted a stun gun?
Well, because he has clothes, everything. I don't know what else to get him, so I just got him a stun gun.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
Okay, so... Then it came, and what happened?
I went upstairs, and I opened it, and I had it for 4 minutes, and I put it back in the drawer.
Mm-hmm.
But the people around us said that I had it for a few days, and I was chasing Blanket and Paris around the house trying to tase them, which is not true, because they didn't know anything about it, and they're on the other side of the house
mm-hmm.
when I got it.
Mm-hmm. How did you actually pay for it?
I went to Rouse and bought a credit card for $50,
uh-huh.
and I ordered it home on it.
How big is the gun?
Well, like that.
Okay, and then describe what it actually does.
Well, there's a button, and there's two prongs like this.
Mm-hmm.
It's pretty small, and when you push it, there's like, you see a little electric thing.
So how close would I have to be to you for you to actually hit me with it?
I just push it in.
So your dad didn't know anything about it.
Mm-mm.
The box came. You then opened up the box, yeah. And you were looking at it. And
yeah, and I tested it on the piece of paper. Then I put it back in the box that I came with and put it in the drawer. Then the security came and took it.
So what was the reaction you got when you put the gun up against the paper?
It was loud and it made it a little hole.
Okay. So when the call came to you, Jermaine, when you were in South Africa, was it somebody from your family or outside of the family? What? Did you immediately say there's no way my son would have a stun gun?
No. I immediately said that he would hurt when he tried to hurt anybody in his family. But I've had a father and son on the most important thing is he's been like really kind of bothered by this because
right.
of the outpour and some of the things that have been said about him. So
right.
I wanted him to just talk to him.
Now. Yeah, you took it out the box. You tested it on a piece of paper,
yeah.
And then you put it back in the box.
Yeah.
And then what happened? How did everybody find out?
Because the security came, and they gave it to my grandma. Then, 2 weeks later, child services come at 10:30 at night, and they came because of the taser incident.
We've read that you held the stun gun up to Blanket and tried to scare him. Was Blanket ever in the same room?
No, he
with
was
the gun?
On the other side of the house.
So Blanket never even saw the gun?
Yeah, it's not true.
You showed it to Your Majesty. You said he knew about it.
He saw it, yeah.
Okay, did you ever hold it up to Your Majesty? You never did that.
Mm-hmm.
What about Prince or Paris? Did you ever show it to them?
Prince saw it, but I didn't point it to him. He just saw it. He saw the box.
Now, let me ask you, Jaafar, do all the kids get along?
We play every day.
Do you?
Yeah.
You play with Prince and Paris and Blanket every day?
We always have plans together. We do everything.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So, I mean, all kids fight at some time, but there's never any...
But see, that's getting out there because it's not the fact that they don't get along. They get along very, very well. Mm-hmm. They play. They miss them when they come to my house. They miss Prince, Paris, and Blanket when they leave and go do things. It's the people that don't want them to get along. They want the people that came with Prince, Paris, and Blanket. And these are the ones who put this mess out there.
Mm-hmm.
And those are the ones that I'm very upset at.
Let me ask you, why don't they want the kids to get along?
Because it has... That's your fault. They're trying to take us out of the house or use this incident. Just trying to say I'm a bad kid, which I'm not, because I'll never try to hurt my cousin at all.
I see. And this is your grandma Catherine's house, right?
Mm-hmm.
So somebody wants you and Your Majesty out of the house.
Yeah. They're just trying to say that I'm a bad kid. So they want my brothers, too, in the house.
That must be very hurtful for you.
Yeah, it hurt me a lot.